Hello humans, some of you asked for the synth in Never Meant To Be, and that's what we are looking at today.
And this is the project for it. It was originally called Stone. It's fairly complicated, and screen recording and looking into this is fairly hard on my CPU. That's why I opened a new project. So this is it. There is basically one version that is bounced, that is affected with some stuff, and the basic sound is in that patch. But let's look on the processing first. When I put everything out, that's how it sounds like. It makes a difference in the mix. Some things are interesting, like there are automations happening always when the reverb is coming in here. And that's maybe not the most elegant way to do this. I just did it because sometimes you end up with ways like this. But you could just cut the waveform and have all those things on a new track, and it would be much easier than to write all those little automations. What are they doing? One of them is controlling the width, because the normal chords were a little too mono and the reverbed part was a little bit too wide, so that's controlling that here with. Then we have an EQ automation going on, which is high passing the sound and later on also low passing it in this EQ. So would be much easier if you do it on a different track. And then we have this automation FX layer, which is this one. And here we have a mid-side split. So the sound is split into mid-signal and side signal. And on both we have a bit reduction. Bit reduction and also sample rate reduction effect. You can do this with every effect, I guess. Mix not too high. And it's basically to give it a little bit of dirt in the high end. Yeah, it makes it a little bit more noisy, but also strangely like better quality because you have more top end. And that's it for the bounce. That's all that's happening. You have those different versions of the chords. They are filtered and also in the intro. There's a lot of reverb on it. But in the end, it's exactly the same chords. So let's look into the sound, how we made the chord sound. There are two basic motions in here. There's this motion, which is pretty similar to the envelope 1/8 envelope mode. And it's happening every time I press a key. And then you have this second sort of reverb and automation, a bunch of other effects. So I'm gonna put those up. Yeah. So let's focus on the first automation first. It's doing the wavetable position, sine wave going to a squarey sine wave. It's doing the cutoff frequency, it's a Moog low pass 12 filter, a little bit of drive, a little bit of resonance. It's also doing the noise level. Noise is not routed through the filter. So this gives it this fairly analog feel. Doing a lot. And of course you have the second oscillator, which is FMing the first at dead center 50, I guess. And but it's also going out. So definitely need this one. Four voices, slightly detuned. It's a basic saw wave. There's not much to it. What's interesting is that the key tracking is also on the filter, and it's kind of exaggerating what the key tracking here is already doing. So the high notes get an even more open filter, and the low notes are getting a closer filter than they would normally get. Like, it's basically like 200% key tracking. Then you have some macros, but I think I didn't use them. No, there are no automations in this. Didn't use them. You have a comp filter moving. High resonance, so you actually hear the comp, but it's only fairly briefly coming in with the keystroke. To show you exactly what it's doing, I just loaded the same filter here so you can see it. So it's basically like, here it's low pass and here it's high, kind of high passing the comp character. So that's on 50%. You also have the key tracking on the cutoff. And it's very subtle, and it's just a little character thing. Now, why do I have this EQ here? Because it's also basically doing nothing, but it actually does a lot. Ah, sounds awful. So there's no gain plugin in the Serum FX, which is kind of annoying. I would love to have a gain on every of those plugins. And then, of course, you have the reverb, the hyper, and the multiband compression. And they are all linked to this automation. And you see, it's not triggered. It's basically repeating every bar. Reverb is fully wet. Hall, small size, mid decay, little bit low cut, little bit high cut, little bit of spin. Hyper, I think that's pretty much standard. There's nothing crazy going on. Also with the OTT. Without the OTT, you feel like the reverb part is kind of in a different world than the rest of it. So this more sounds like just a stretched version of the short chord sound. And that's basically it. And then we're going with this chord structure into it. Yeah, now my computer is dying. And after it, there's some exciter, just put it out. Exciter and some EQ. Making it even brighter. But these are steps that go a long way, and sometimes you need them, sometimes you don't need them. It really depends on the track and how it goes with the other elements. Most important, I think, is that the sound is played rhythmically in a place where it grooves, you know, and that's what makes it cool and makes it bouncy. On its own, it's just a sound. Alright, if you didn't understand everything, let us know in the comments, and also if you want to see something else, please tell us. So, yeah, see you next time. We were never meant to be.